Hi, this is Dr. Stephen Melton. I'm the interim pastor here at Irvington Presbyterian Church. I wanted to read to you a few verses from the book of James. Here's what James says in chapter 2. What good is it, my brothers and sisters, if you say you have faith but do not have works? Can faith save you? If a brother or sister is naked and lacks daily food, and one of you says to them, go in peace, keep warm, eat your fill, and yet do nothing to supply for their bodily needs, what good is that? So faith by itself, if it has no works, is dead. And James sums it up in one verse, in chapter 1, verse 27. Religion that is pure and undefiled before God the Father is this: to care for orphans and widows in their distress, and to keep oneself unstained by the world. So one of the things we try to do here at Irvington Presbyterian Church is to remember what James says. Remember those who are orphaned or widowed, or those who are hungry in need of clothing. We do that in various ways, through the ICANN ministry, through opportunities we have to collect food to give away regularly at our church. But most specifically today, we want to talk about our senior ministry with Denise Harrington. Denise is one of those who works for those to reach out to senior citizens who may sometimes be overlooked and dealing with Alzheimer's.
Hello, I'm Denise Jones Harrington, and I'm the senior ministry consultant here at Irvington Presbyterian Church. And we're coming today to talk to you about Family Caregiver Month. And so I have with me...
Hi, I'm Jim Little. I've been a member here for 48 years. And I have been coming to the Alzheimer's Support Group meeting for the past 8 years. This is one of the ways that the church supports helping people through the stewardship.
Okay, wonderful. And so we just want to kind of talk about that. We do this Alzheimer's Support Group here at Irvington, and it's important ministry that we provide, and it's available to the community. It's free. You don't have to be a member of Irvington to be a part of the group, and we really feel like this is an important ministry that the church provides. And this month in November is Family Caregiver Month, and so basically the focus is to really give support to people who are family caregivers. Many people don't even know that they'll ever be a family caregiver.
Correct.
You know?
Yes.
And then all of a sudden here it is, and we found out in the United States now there are approximately 42.5 million people who are providing free family support care. And so what we learned from the National Alliance of Caregivers is that in the last 5 years, from 2015 to 2020, there have been 9.5 million more caregivers. So, Jim, why would you say that the support group is important?
It's very important because it gives you something to get off your chest. Because sometimes you feel alone as a caregiver, and when you find out there's other people that are in the same situation, it makes you feel better. So sometimes it's just release of tension,
yeah.
I believe.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Which really helps.
Yeah, exactly. Just to know that you're not alone is an important part of it. And we find that most of the people that come here are just grateful that they have the opportunity to come here and be a part of this group, that Irvington is really important to them. We had a lady today that said she found out about us through the website.
Yeah, so. And she seemed to be very happy with what we did today. So I think we helped her tremendously.
Yeah.
Let's hope so.
Wonderful.
So now that you've learned a little bit about the ministry that Denise Harrington leads for us, we keep in mind that one of the most important ways that we celebrate that ministry is through baptism. It is through baptism that we become members of the body of Christ, and we dedicate ourselves to the life of being a Christian. And so here now, Mo is going to tell us something about that in the role of life of our church.
Hello. As we continue in stewardship season, we have this Sunday an excellent symbol of both stewardship and the faith that we share together. One of the big questions that sometimes come up is, why don't we have baptisms with just the family and no one there? Why is it always the congregation? And it's an important part of a baptism sacrament is that we as a congregation make promises to whoever is being baptized, whether it be a child or a youth or adult, that we are there for them and that they are a part of this church. We make promises, and it's the same way that promises were made for us in our baptism. And part of that is being a good steward of our earth, of our congregation, and of our church. So this Sunday, when we have that baptism, when we remember not only our own baptisms and celebrate the joining and the promises made for this young child, is part of being a good steward of our congregation so that it can continue to be a part of their faith life for the day that they're baptized until the day that they leave. So again, this Sunday, we remember our baptism, the promises that are made, and the promises that are shared. We'll see you Sunday. Whoa.